Hi everyone and welcome back to the channel. And in today's video, I'm going to show you how can you create a complete image generation system using AI, which not only creates actually on-brand images, but gets you an output which looks like this. Again, something that is actually real, can work with your brand, and you don't need to keep figuring out, is AI going to respond with the right image this time? So let's see how to build a complete system. This system is built on Airtable, so you get posts like this. I'm going to walk you through the whole process, but first, let's start with a quick demo. So first things first, I'm going to come here back to grid view, right? And the only thing we need to do is we need to define what do we want in the post. So I'm just going to write a topic. So I'm going to take a topic, for example, very simply learning AI with friends, right? And I'm going to put some notes. So this is just like, you know, what do I want in the image of the post, right? As an option, I am just going to say, how can you use AI to learn together, right? I'm going to write audience as general, and then we are going to leave this, the final post and the image template. This is the only thing that we need to select. So I'm going to click on plus and you will see a list of templates. So I can see the image that I want to select. So I will select this particular image. And with that, I'm pretty much done. I just need to ensure that this process AI option is created and then I can come here and click on execute workflow. Now this workflow is going to go ahead and create a new brand new image using Google Slides as a template and then update all of that data into a single piece. I'm going to walk you through the whole system, right, again, and also how to build these templates and bring them back to Google Slides. Again, this workflow will really help you build amazing marketing assets which are extremely on brand and really work with your brand, really work with your brand identity. Because most of the times what happens is images like this are not generatable by AI. We try a lot, but apparently they are still missing and you don't have to keep figuring out. You can use a library of templates that you can create and I'll tell you how to do that. But very simply, let this run so you can see the demo. Now, as you can see, the AI has gone ahead and updated the tools, right? Again, it has updated the Google Slide template. Now it is going ahead and downloading a PDF, converting into an image. And then finally, I should have a final image linked here. As you can see, I can go ahead and click on this. And now I will see the final image that we have. So learning AI together with friends, you have study AI groups, share lessons and explain with friends, collaborate on mini projects, run study sessions weekly. Completely exactly in the same brand format that we want. Gives the right idea, gives the right design, and you can use this image right apart. Not only that, you also get an editable version of this image, which I'll show you how you can find that. So you can edit it if required without breaking ahead. So let's get into the workflow. Okay, so now let me walk you through the whole automation and then I'll tell you exactly how did I build this. Very simply, first let's start on the first process where it is pulling data from Airtable. This is a simple trigger. Whenever I click this execute workflow button, it runs this. This is a simple trigger where it gets me the values from the Airtable. So this is my Airtable. In the content automation table, whenever I click this button on whichever row, it takes up that particular row and brings that back. So again, based on that, it takes and gets me all this information on the right hand side, which is all the details about the post. So the topic, the post notes, the audience, the image template, everything else. Once that is done, I create a copy of the image template. When I'm talking to you about the template, I'm talking about this particular place. This is a Google slide, which is created for my particular brand, which is the Better with AI community. You can join that if you want to build AI systems for your own business and learn how to do that quickly. But again, this is a post that we have created for that. Now, again, as you can see, this is all placeholder text. So this is what I mean when I mean the word template. So in here, we have the copy of the template created. And then in the AI agent, it's very... The most amount of effort that I took was writing on this prompt. This prompt is extremely, extremely massive, right? Again, not only massive, length does not mean anything, but it's extremely detailed and really, really follows a very particular requirement of what I needed to do. After that is done, it also takes the input from here, from all the details. So the raw thoughts, the topic, the JSON, and then runs the, and then takes these instructions up and then uses this particular tool, which is a Google Slide tool, of the copy that it just created here on the Google Drive note, takes that and updates the text there. So if you see, this particular text is updated after that. I can also show you that here very simply. Every time it has updated the text. So it searches for the text and updates the template text there. So that, again, it is able to replace and modify that. Then after all of this is done, this is just simply, I've kept it as like, you know, the GPT-5 model. I'm using the GPT-5 mini model because it's really, really good at tool function calling and helps me out a lot. After that, this slide gets downloaded as a PDF. And this is a very stupid reason why I have to do that, because in the n8n node, you don't allow it to download it as an image. It only allows to PDF, but it's just like stupid because there is an option to download it as an image here. So if you are going to Google Slides, you can download it from an image, but it's fine. We do convert it into a PDF, and then this PDF gets converted into an image. The image gets uploaded into Google Drive, and then we technically update the particular link available here. So if you go here, you get the final image link available in this particular description, okay? So again, pretty simple. You get the image, you are happy, everything works, and that's there. But again, let me tell you a couple of more things that you need to do. So if you want to replicate this system, this whole particular automation is available in our community, and you can join that from the description below. But again, let me tell you what you need to set this up. So very simply, first of all, you need an Airtable. Now Airtable is pretty simple, right? Again, very simply, I have a topic, a process AI option, right? Again, this is just a simple checkbox, right? You can edit the field and you get a checkbox option. I've just selected the checkbox. After that, I post notes. So these are just like, you know, again, thoughts or like, you know, anything that you want to input. I just call them raw thoughts, like, you know, just input your details on what you want the image to have. Then you select an audience. You can obviously modify this audience as you require, right? Again, you can have multiple audience information. And final image is just a URL node. But this particular image template is where things get a bit informative, right? What you have to do. So this is another table that we have. So this looks like this, right? Again, this is very simply, it has four options. It has an image JSON, right? And then it has an image template ID. And then again, sample is just something I've created for option. But very simply, we just need two fields here, image JSON and the image template ID. And the way to create these images is by showing you an example. So this is Canva. Again, you can see that I have a couple of images here. I'm going to show you this, what we created here. Again, we changed this to main CTA, and then we have subheading and subheading two. I'll show you this from an easier example. So this is my image that we are going to utilize for creating a lot of stories about what is happening in AI, right? And this is going to be like a news option. Now again, always coming back to Canva and uploading this and changing this is going to be too difficult. So what we have done is, instead of the headline here, I've written this main CTA four words. Now when I've written main CTA four words, only thing I need to do is click on share, download, and very simply download this particular page as a Google Slides template. So very simply go to PPTX and, like, you know, download it as a PowerPoint template. Now it will take a second or so to download, and once this is downloaded, right, again, as you can see downloaded, I'm going to come back here to my Google Drive, right, and upload this particular drive here. I have uploaded this here, and once you uploaded this as a PPTX, it will open like this. Now again, this is in case you don't know what you need to do now. Okay, now once you have this, again, you can obviously update this, like, you know, as the title. I'm going to update this to very simply say image test, right? And then the only thing you need to do is you need to copy the ID. So the ID is just this particular part of the URL. You just need to copy that URL ID. And once we have that ID ready, we can come back to our Airtable. Now in this particular, in the image options table, I'm going to create new, and I'm going to, not a view, I'm just going to create, like, add an option. I'm going to say image with CTA, or like a headline image. This is, again, you can write anything here. This is just for you to remember what you are talking about. And in this, we are going to paste image template ID. And this, in the JSON format, you need to input whatever you want to replace. So I technically am happy with everything else. As you can see, the font is a bit different because of probably Google Slides. But very simply, I want this particular to be changed. So very simply, I'm going to copy this, right? And in the JSON part, I'm going to come back here in the image JSON and just create curly braces and paste this whole thing in a single place, right? So I'm just going to paste this whole thing here, like main CTA, four words. And you need to make sure that you are exactly copying and pasting it there. So for example, if this has, like, if this has no space, right, then you can't, like, you know, add any space. So then simply this needs to look like this. So it needs to be exactly what you want here, right? Again, you can, like, also just, like, write main CTA. I always write it with words because AI knows that you exactly want just four words here. If it is more, it starts making the image a bit difficult to process. So given that this is very simple, I'm just going to post this here. And then again, for your own reference, what you can do is you can take a quick, like, you know, download this as an image, right? We are just going to quickly download this as a JPEG. So you can, in your Airtable, you can drag and drop this file here. So you at least have this as a sample. So when you are referencing, you don't need to remember what image you are talking about, and you will be able to just reference this particular image when you're trying to create. Okay, so now once this is there, what you can do now here is, if I just select your testing, instead of this image, I can click on this and select headline image. and now it will be able to utilize this headline image to process my final output. I can just say testing n8n, and I don't need any post notes here, but I will tell you why do I add post notes. How does someone use n8n as a beginner? Right, and this is the whole idea. So we post this here, headline image, and everything else is done. Now I will walk you through step by step on everything that happens here, and also give you a bonus tip on what you can use on the prompt that I've given it to add one more quick field here. Okay, so let me bring you to this part. Let's start by walking you through. So as the workflow progresses, I'll explain you everything that's happening. So very simply, you're going to click on execute workflow. Now, once you click execute workflow, you have this Airtable trigger, right? Again, it brought in like, you know, exactly how does someone use n8n as a beginner. It brought on all the details, given that we are only processing one option here. And as you can see, I have a simple formula filter here. If processed by AI is true, then only bring that. Again, this is pretty simple. Then it has created a copy of the template. So it took the template ID, which is this particular template, and created a copy of it because we want to change that template. And now it has gone ahead and started updating. Okay, probably got an error here. Okay, so the error reason was pretty simple. Very simply, when you are doing all of this, when I imported this from Canva, you need to make one more step, is click on save as Google Slides. Now once that is done, let me walk you through step by step what happens, right? Again, very simply, we're going to click on execute workflow, right? Again, and what's going to happen now is it's going to create a copy of the template. First, it found all the details about what we want to process. So this is, that means exactly this particular option here, right? Again, that we created is going to copy all of this information, and it brought all the information available here. And once it brought it, as you can see, it is now going ahead and using the agent to run through and create using GPT-5 the image template. It's going to update the image template. And the best thing now is that you can see the logs here on what is exactly happening rather than trying to click on the workflow. So as you can see, it has gone ahead and updated the presentation, right? So technically, our image should already be ready, but to convert it into an image format, we need to go through the following process. And it also creates a Twitter post for you, which I'll show you exactly on how you can use that. As you can see, it's going ahead and executing that particular node also. And in a second, I'll tell you how you can utilize that. But again, very simply, the next steps are pretty simple. I use a option called Cloud Convert, right? You can just search for this from here and get Cloud Convert. And you can get this to convert anything into a file, into an image. And very simply, this downloads the PDF. As you can see, it takes this particular information here, downloads this as a file, sends this to this particular Cloud Convert option, converts this into an image, and then finally uploads this image into the Google Drive and then updates the image link. So now let's see, moment of truth. You will get your images available here in the final image option. And let's see now the moment of truth, right? Again, let's click here and okay, perfect. Test n8n workflows now. As you can see, this particular, like, you know, information is changed, and then it updates that. And that's how you can create an on-brand template. So the best way to do that is, like, you know, again, three steps. Create a ton of templates in Canva. You can already use Canva templates. Just change these words and then simply upload these words into your image system here. So you can have an image options. You can even hire someone off from Fiverr or like an intern to do this, and very quickly, like, you know, just create a ton of templates, plug this back into the system that's available here, and you can create unlimited content. Another trick that I want to show you, not a trick, but something that I built, but only for the people who have stayed till the end, is simply, if you come here, there is also an option to add a post. So when you think final post, I already have added in the whole content, the AI agent will also give you an output of tweets and details. So what you can do is take all of this content, right, which has all the details. So if you see here, it has Twitter for tweets to automate smoke and XYZ. It has all the details. It also creates a LinkedIn post for you if you need it, and you can convert this into a LinkedIn post. But very simply, it also gives you a lot of content to attach with the image. So it's not only the image, it's also this particular content. I hope you enjoyed the video, and you can create now a ton of on-brand content, which is super easy. But at the same time, if you want to implement this system, you have two options. You can go ahead and build this, or if you want to download this, you can go below and join the school community, where you get hundreds of these templates and also exclusive support from my team to setting this up, and also a ton of other n8n automations. With that, thank you so much for watching, and I love to see you in the next one.